हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ग्रेड अप, इंडियाज़ लार्जेस्ट लाइव लर्निंग प्लेटफॉर्म। सही प्रेप है तो लाइफ सेट है। तो इन दिस ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम कैप्सूल 02, वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट SJF CPU शेड्यूलिंग एल्गोरिदम, दैट इज़ शॉर्टेस्ट जॉब फर्स्ट। सो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग, आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट टू ऑल ऑफ यू टू प्लीज़ लाइक दिस सेशन, शेयर विद योर फ्रेंड्स एंड सब्सक्राइब टू ग्रेड अप यूट्यूब चैनल। तो SJF CPU शेड्यूलिंग एल्गोरिदम। So before starting, let me introduce myself. My name is Anshul Sharma. I have 1+ years of teaching experience and mentoring GATE CS aspirants. In GATE 2020, I have secured All India Rank 294. I have also qualified ISRO and NEET exam. My area of expertise is operating system, digital logic, compiler design, DBMS, discrete mathematics, and computer networks. So those who want to prepare for GATE 2022 or 2023, so they can subscribe to Grade Up Super for Vision 2022 English batch, for Vision 2022 Hindi batch, and for Vision 2023 Hindi or English batch. For all these streams, it is available. So in this batch, you are going to get 850 plus hours of live classes, 8000 plus practice questions, 100 plus chapter wise study notes, and 120 plus mock test. So subscribe to Grade Up Super. And for more information, you can contact on this number, that is 965005-2904. And you can connect with me on Telegram. So this is the link for that Telegram group. So that is Anshul_Sharma_CS. So you can join this group and you can get the PDFs of all the YouTube classes, right? Doubt clearances and guidance as well, right? So you can join and connect with me on Telegram. So let's start shortest job first CPU scheduling algorithm. In the previous class, we have seen FCFS. Now we are going to see SJF. So what is the criteria? The criteria here is that it is based on burst time. It is based on burst time, that is, or you can say CPU time as well, or you can say service time, right? Everything is same. Burst time, CPU time, or service time. And the mode is non-preemptive. That means if you have allocated the CPU to any of the one process, then until its completion, you cannot take the CPU back, right? That means it is going to schedule till its completion. So let's see through an example. Let's understand through an example how this shortest job first CPU scheduling algorithm will schedule the processes. Suppose we have five processes here. Suppose this is P1, this is P2, this is P3, this is P4, and this is P5. Okay, so arrival time is given to us and burst time is given to us. We have to calculate completion time, turnaround time, waiting time, and response time. So let's schedule these processes. So in shortest job first, as the name suggests, we are going to consider the burst time. The process which is going to have the least burst time, we are going to schedule that process first based on the arrival time as well. That means at 0 units of time, first we have to see which process arrived in the ready queue. So if you see the arrival time of all the processes, at 0 units of time, we don't have any process present in the ready queue. That means for 1 unit of time, the CPU is going to sit idle because there is no process present in the ready queue to schedule it, right? Now at 1 unit of time, you can see P1 process has arrived because the arrival time of P1 is 1. So now I can schedule P1 process, and as it is non-preemptive, so I'm going to schedule this process till its completion. The burst time is 7, so 1 plus 7, it is going to be 8, and here I can make it 0. So P1 has completed its execution. Now at 8 units of time, you can see P2 has arrived, P3, P4, and P5. That means all the remaining processes have arrived in the ready queue. Now you have to compare the burst time of all the processes. So if you compare the burst time of all the remaining 4 processes, you will find out that P3 is having the least burst time. So we are going to schedule P3 process. So 8 plus 1, as the burst time is 1, so 8 plus 1, it is going to be 9. And we can make it 0. P3 has completed its execution. Clear? Now, out of the remaining processes, you can see P4 process is having the least burst time. So we are going to schedule P4 process now. 9 plus 2, it is going to be 11. Here I can make it 0 and P4 has completed its execution. Now out of P2 and P5, P2 is going to have the least burst time and we are going to schedule that first. So 11 plus 5, it is going to be 16. Here I can make it 0 and P2 has completed its execution. In the end, we are going to schedule P5 process. The burst time is 8, so 16 plus 8, it is going to be 24. We can make it 0 and P5 has completed its execution. Here, now based on this chart, we can write the completion time of all the processes. For P1, the completion time is 8. For P2, the completion time is 16. For P3, the completion time is 9. For P4, it is 11. And for P5, it is 24. Now we can find the turnaround time. So what is turnaround time? Turnaround time is equal to completion time minus arrival time. Right. So we can find the turnaround time as well. That is completion time minus arrival time. 8 minus 1, it is 7. 16 minus 2, it is going to be 14. 9 minus 3, it is 6. 11 minus 4, it is 7. 24 minus 8, that is going to be 19. Now we can find the waiting time as well. Waiting time is turnaround time minus burst time, initial burst time. Right, so waiting time, turnaround time minus burst time, 7 minus 7, it is going to be 0. 14 minus 5, it is going to be 9. 6 minus 1, that is 5. 7 minus 2, it is 5. 19 minus 8, it is 11. Now, as we know, in case of non-preemptive CPU scheduling algorithms, always the waiting time will be equal to the response time. Still, you can find out what is response time. Response time is first time CPU allocation. First time CPU allocation minus arrival time. That is going to be your response time. So here you can see the first time we have allocated the CPU to P1 at 1 unit of time. So 1 minus 1, it is going to be 0. For P2, it is 11. So 11 minus 2, it is going to be 9. Right? For P3, it is 8. So 8 minus 3, it is going to be 5. So you can compare. The waiting time is equal to response time. Here. Now you can find out the average turnaround time. You can add all the values of turnaround time of all the processes and you can divide by the number of processes. Similarly, you can calculate average waiting time as well. Right. So if you solve this here, you are going to get 7 plus 14. It is going to be 21. 21 plus 6, that is 27. 27 plus 7, that is going to be 34. 34 plus 19, that is going to be 53. Right. Divided by 5 will give you the average turnaround time. Clear? Now, what about average waiting time? That is going to be 10 and this is 20, so this is going to be 30. 30 divided by 5, that is going to give you the average waiting time. And average response time is also going to be same, because in case of non-preemptive, in case of all non-preemptive CPU scheduling algorithms, waiting time is always equal to response time. Clear? So in this way, using shortest job first, we can schedule the processes. And there is one thing that we cannot implement shortest job first CPU scheduling algorithm practically. Why? Because it is based on burst time. And in advance, we don't know the burst time of the processes. We can approximate the value, but we don't know the exact value of the burst time for all the processes, right? So that is why this shortest job first or whichever algorithm is based on burst time, that is not practically implementable. Okay, fine. So these are the star faculties we have at GradeUp for computer science, and they will be teaching you in all the courses of computer science, right? And in GATE 2021, we have 10 plus gradients under AR10 among all the streams. So that is a big achievement for GradeUp and its students. You can subscribe to GradeUp Super and you will be getting unlimited access to structured life courses. Green card is also included in this. So India's best faculty, complete doubt resolution, full syllabus coverage, 100 plus online mock test designed by the toppers based on latest exam pattern. For any more information, you can contact on this number 965005294. You can also install GradeUp app from Play Store and there you can attend all the free app classes, as well as you can attempt all the free mock tests, right? And if you want to prepare in a well-structured manner, then you can go for Grade Up Super. So thank you everyone for joining this class. I hope you have learned shortage of first CPU scheduling algorithm. So in the next class, we are going to see other CPU scheduling algorithm. Till then, take care and bye-bye.